Now, the possible deployment of THAAD is widely expected to hijack the first foreign ministers' meeting in 3 years between South Korea, China, and Japan this weekend. Our Hwang Sung-hee has a preview.
When the top diplomats from Korea, China, and Japan meet on Saturday, they'll discuss ways to restore trilateral cooperation amid strained relations. Tangled in territorial and historical disputes, the talks in Seoul are the first such meeting since 2012. Korea, as the current rotating chair, has been pushing for a gathering of the top diplomats since late last year. But Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi may have another agenda in mind.
Since the visit to Korea by Chinese Defense Minister Chang Won-chan, China has been very vocal about its position on THAAD. It is highly likely that the issue will be brought up again.
Korean Foreign Minister Yoon Byung-se will hold separate meetings with the visiting diplomats ahead of the trilateral talks, giving the Chinese minister an opportunity to reiterate Beijing's concerns. On Monday, a senior Chinese diplomat called on Korea to consider Beijing's concerns before deploying the U.S. missile defense system. Seoul says its decision will be based on national interest. There are also questions about whether Korea and Japan will make progress on the issue of Japan's wartime sexual enslavement of Korean women, especially since this is Japanese Foreign Minister Fumio Kishida's first trip to Seoul since taking office in 2012. The visiting ministers are also scheduled to meet with President Park Geun-hye ahead of the trilateral meeting. While Seoul and Tokyo have expressed hopes that Saturday's talks will lead to a trilateral summit, experts say that Beijing will likely remain cautious and make sure that Prime Minister Shinzo Abe apologizes for Japan's wartime atrocities before setting a date. Hwang Sung-hee, Arirang News.
On a related note, Beijing's foreign ministry says that the three countries do indeed plan on discussing the prospect of a trilateral summit. The ministry spokesperson, however, added that the right political environment should be established first, noting that historical differences among the three parties is what caused the impasse.